The committee visited the Nkuranguru Health Center and the plot envisaged for the Nkuranguru District Hospital. The Nkuranguru Health Center project has been abandoned for about 3 years now, since construction started in 2014. The contractor abandoned the site after it was discovered that building plans lack project specifications. The Nkuranguru District Hospital project could also not take off the ground since the groundbreaking ceremony by former President Hifikepunye Pohamba in November 2014. The 1,000-hectare plot where the hospital is envisaged was fenced off, but a government freeze on new projects stalled the commencement of the project. The committee chairperson says in most of the regions visited so far, progress on capital projects was disappointing.
We are heartbroken where we are coming from because we started with Kunene region. The projects that we visited from 2015 when we were sworn in parliament, till to date you go there, it's still the bush that welcomes you. Yet when the budget comes in the motivational speech, they are full of cream and sugar.
Sekongo says the delays mean people in the new region will continue to travel long distances for basic services. Another capital project that has not taken off the ground is the construction of the Kavango West Government Park.
Today, as we are speaking, we are renting offices that are costing us a lot of money. We are supposed to construct an office for us to have a nice office. You have seen our boardroom there. Even the governor is running to our boardroom. The governor does not have a boardroom. She rents a house. And in that house, there's no boardroom.
Sekongo says $18 million has been spent on earthworks, but it is unknown when actual construction will start. The construction of the Rupara Youth Skills Development Center is another project that has been delayed, mainly due to the contractor failing to deliver the project on time.